He was a martial artist instructor, and he worked with children. He developed almost a bond, a lifelong bond with these people.
Alonzo Brown doubled as a martial arts instructor and a licensed real estate agent. Postal inspectors say he would often help clients buy their first homes, but then...
Within weeks after the purchase, she was told that there was some problem with the paperwork, which was a lie, and that she needed to re-sign some documents relating to this transaction, which was a lie.
With this paperwork sleight of hand, Brown had victims co-signing loans for additional homes.
The person didn't know at that time that they were signing for new homes, and it would happen over and over in a very short period of time.
Initially, Brown was making the mortgage payments and often selling the properties for profit or borrowing against any equity earned on the home. Victims had no idea their names were being used.
People that were close with the suspect and people that trusted him to do the right thing, and he didn't.
That wasn't all. While postal inspectors were investigating this scheme, they found more.
The suspect in this case was not only effectively perpetrating a very large mortgage fraud scheme involving millions of dollars, but then at the same time he was fleecing another consumer or another person by saying that he was this investment genius and he could get these double your money within minutes.
Brown told victims they could double their investment. Again, they trusted him, and some lost everything.
It's absolutely too good to be true. I mean, doubling money, millions of dollars within days.
Postal inspectors say investors need to be on the lookout for promises of unrealistic returns and always do their research.
When you're giving somebody money as an investment, it's very important that you vet who this is, that you check them out, that you find out whether or not they're with an established institution.